A popular antibiotic may be linked to sudden onset heart problems, according to a long-running study from Vanderbilt University. Researchers studied data on antibiotics given to more than 500,000 Medicaid patients in Tennessee. Among those who took a 5-day treatment of Zithromax, 29 patients died of heart-related ailments. Joining us now with more on the study and its implications is Dr. Warren Levy, a cardiologist with Virginia Heart. Thanks for coming in, sir. Appreciate it.
Good morning.
I have to tell you, when I heard about this yesterday, now I'm one of millions of people who has taken Zithromax. I was quite alarmed. You came in a little while ago and you and I have chatted, and you've already made me feel a little bit better. Put this, tell us what the study shows, and can you put it in perspective for us?
Sure. First, let's not all get too excited. This is a retrospective study, so they just reviewed medical records as opposed to a study which you go forward and test the medication. And it showed what other similar medications in that class of antibiotics have probably shown, and that is there is an increased risk, especially to patients with cardiovascular disease, of taking certain medications because they can potentially have an effect on the electrical system of the heart. Now, the numbers were very small. When you convert it to number of deaths per million patients treated, patients who either took nothing or took amoxicillin had about 30 deaths per million patients in the 5 days. People who took azithromycin or the Z-Pak had 85 deaths per million. So the numbers are extremely small. But it does raise the question. The FDA has said, we're going to look at this now to see if we need to increase our warnings about this medication. But it's very similar to the other macrolid antibiotics like erythromycin, which is in the same class, and clarithromycin, which is Biaxin. They're all known to affect the electrical system of the heart. And in certain situations, it can cause a chaotic heart rhythm that can lead to death.
Okay. So the numbers are low. But if you're one of those 85 people, you know, it doesn't matter that the numbers are low. You've died possibly because
we don't take it lightly, and you're absolutely right.
Right.
What it does is I think it raises a warning. It reminds physicians and it reminds patients. Number one, you don't take antibiotics unless you really need them. Mm-hmm. We prescribe far too many antibiotics for what ends up being viral illnesses. So we need to be careful. We need to be especially careful in using certain classes of antibiotics that can have this electrical effect on the heart. And then we need to be especially careful in using these classes of medications in patients who have cardiovascular disease, because in that group, it increased the risk by about 250 deaths per million patients treated.
My producer had a very good question this morning. She wanted to know, is there a risk if you've ever taken this drug, or is it when you're taking it? Like if you took it 3 years ago, are you at risk?
Great question. For this particular medication, it's during the time that you take it. And in fact, most of the deaths occurred between days 4 and 5 of therapy. Normally it's a 5-day course of therapy. So that if the risk occurs when you're taking it, it has an acute electrical effect on the heart. It prolongs what we call the QT interval. It's something we can measure on an electrocardiogram, and it would have the effect then. Once it's out of your system, you're done. It's not like some of these other medications like the COX inhibitors in which it increases the risk of heart attacks. This is a very different issue. People shouldn't throw their antibiotics down the toilet. Talk to your physicians. But if you're going to be given an antibiotic, be sure you need it, maybe question it, and then for physicians out there, it just increases our awareness that we need to be much more careful with these medications, as well as a lot of the medications that can interact together to cause the same electrical effect.
And physicians need to ask their patients about their history, and patients need to also give that information about their heart history, what other medications are taking.
We make all of our patients bring all their pills with them, because so often patients don't know what they're taking, and that becomes critically important. Your physicians need to know what you're taking before they can prescribe other medications.
Very good. That's great. Thank you for coming in and putting this in perspective.
Have a good day,
Dr.
Tony.
Dr.
Yep.
Levy. Yep.
The Fox 5 weather app. Look 10 days ahead or hour by hour. View today's video forecast and radar that can pinpoint your neighborhood free at your app store or Android market.